Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Nioh. So today, I was going to do a few submissions, because, well, I mean, I could probably end up doing the Ocean Roars again. I'm not going to say I'm afraid of it. Due to my level and my excessive co-op, and if you're wondering just how much co-op, this should give you a decent answer. Right here, I have over 500 Choco Cups. That's misleading, though, because a lot of hosts end up dying and you don't end up getting any of Choco Cups, so... hundreds of sessions already. Don't you get bored doing the same few areas? No. Anyway, we're gonna be going... actually, I might end up doing two, because this looks to be pretty short. I was gonna try and do Guardian of the Underworld, and then, if I have time, try and do the Three Angry Gods. So, let's get going. Here, we're going to be trying to help Fuku close the gap between the Yokai realm and, well, the world that they inhabit. I think that's what we're doing. Let's see. Soon it will be entirely beyond our control. I can use my powers to take you to the Yokai realm. Will you in return use your powers to tame the Yokai hordes? Okay, so we're just here to kill a bunch of Yokai. Sounds like a plan to me, lady. So let's get going. By the way, I did forge my own weapons here. I've learned from the follies of my... I'm not picking up gear that I don't plan to use. I'm disassembling a lot of gear now, so I'm getting a lot of, smithing materials for the future. So you don't have to go, pick up some stuff, you idiot! I am doing that now. Boy, you just dropped me in here with nothing to do, with no howdy-do, don't you? Alright, I guess I can just go around and see what happens. Do I hear chanting? I think I hear chanting. That's always a good sign. I guess I am in the Nether realm. That makes sense, right? You gotta have some music going on, even if it's hell, right? I mean, I don't know. It seems like this is just a big old gauntlet, isn't it? Fine by me. I can do a gauntlet. Especially with my makeup here. Or my build, rather. Excuse me, not makeup. Oh, good God. Okay, we're gonna... Okay, now. We're gonna go this way, huh? Fine by me. You'd actually hit anything with that. I hit one, I hit two of them. There we go. Just gotta get some wide-sweeping arcs going on here. Instead of going with the whole speed thing. What is that big thing? Is that a skeleton warrior? No, that's just... a really big... whatever in the world that is. I've never seen one quite so big before. Just makes it easier to hit. Really. Which, helps me because that is one of my downfalls. I'm not really the greatest accuracy person when it comes to swinging at times. There's a yoki right behind me. Okay, there's two of them. Oh my. I just broke your horns. I figured out that's why they sometimes do that. You break their horns in the lore, and they kind of just lose what power they have. So I've been trying to aim for the horns a little more recently, though. To be fair, I'm not exactly doing a fantastic job of that right now, but... wait for it. There we go. Wait for the opportunity. That's good. And there's something behind me now. Oh, hello. Big boy. Oh, hell. Okay. Now's not quite yet the time to panic. We're reaching there. Okay, now's time to panic a little bit. Just a little bit. Because I would like to try and thin this herd out a little bit. Try and keep my living weapon up as long as I can. But unfortunately, it's gone now, and it's over. Guess I used that precisely the correct time. That was a neat little gauntlet. I like that. Would have preferred if they didn't throw quite so many at you at the same time. But for the mission length, that's okay. Is there any actual items here, or are we just like what you kill? You claim what you kill. Looks to be that. Just claim what you kill, man. That was neat. That didn't take very long. That only took. Like 3 or 4 minutes. So yeah, we can go to the next area. Should have probably ended up using a Carnage Talisman while I was using the, what do you call it, the spirit weapon, but, or living weapon, excuse me. Oh, that's right, I forgot to tell you, I did level up some skills that you're probably going to go, what in the hell did you level those up for? You don't even use those weapons. Well, I'll tell you here in a minute, I'll show you. I leveled up, Indomitable Spirit, because I think that counts even if you're not using a sword. Now, from what I've heard, I don't think the Mystic Arts work if you're not using that particular weapon, but the passives do, in fact, work. So, arguably, there was no point in me getting Kick, but I had to get it to get the Spirit. I also was thinking about getting Cornered Tiger, right? Because, I mean, that's another passive. It'd be 8 Samurai points down the drain, but... I'm not sure about that one yet. No, think about it. It's, you know, Ki regeneration, always good. Attack, kind of always good. I got the points for it, so why not, right? Yeah, get those passives. I love passives. Passives are great, even if they're niche like that. It also really synergizes well with my particular guardian spirit because, if I can find it here, I think it's on this screen, one of them. Yeah, tenacity. Tenacity basically means the lower health you are when you go into living weapon, the more damage you do, I think. Let me see if that's actually what it says. Effectiveness is active when your health is under a certain level. So yeah, that really, you know, synergizes well with that. I tend to use that when I'm low on health in a boss fight with this particular one because it gives you a lot more damage. Oh, also, I forgot to do that as well. I have a lot more extra titles. I'm not going to stay real long here, but just to show you what I do have on the different ones, like the different factions here. Because I've been doing quite a lot. I haven't been using different weapons because I like trying to get my, what's the word, expertise? Is that what they call it? I don't know, but we're getting our bonuses here. Let's see. Human close combat damage is what I want. Toughness. I love having toughness. I love having guard. I want extra Ki. I love having extra Ki. I burned through it really quickly with that heavy armor I'm wearing. I think that affects how much Ki it takes to attack. I think, didn't it? How much, like, how heavy your armor is? I'm pretty sure that's how it is. I'm just clicking the same ones because this is the bonuses I like. I want to focus on the big bonuses that I like and focus on them and try and get those as high as possible. Let's see. Yokai Realm, I don't really need. Omnio Magic Power, eh. I'll go with life. That's always a safe bet. You need more life. I like having durability living weapons. I like utilizing the living weapons when I'm in a bad way. And if I'm in a bad way, I am probably going to get hit. Whether that logic holds up underwater, I don't know. But that's my reasoning. I love having extra luck. Love it. Who doesn't like finding more exotics? I mean, who the hell would say, Nar, I don't want more exotics. I want the crappy uncommons. A lunatic, that's who. Or someone trying to make the game harder on themselves. I guess. Extra Amrita's never a bad thing, so. Yeah, what I was talking about was I'm going to imagine, if I can find it here, where was it? Proficiency! Right, my axe proficiency is why I was trying to use dual swords a little more there. My axe proficiency seems to be all the way filled up on that little bar. I don't know what that means. But, that's why I'm trying to use dual swords a little more. So, yes, that's the plan. So now we can go to the three angry gods. Because this should be funny. Before I do that, though, I want to level up. Okay, well, I'll just have to use a few Amrita to do such a thing. But, let's say I need 95,000, so let me get my... Go to my usable items. I really should probably not have quite so many things here. Oh, I need to disassemble those while I'm thinking about it, but... Let's see, where are they? Small spirit stones. I need 7 of them. Alright, that's what I'm going to use these for in the future, so yeah. Let me go shrine first, level up first. And then we can disassemble that, show that how that process works before I forget to do it. And as you can see, the stats haven't changed all that much. I've added some heart because I like getting key. I like having extra key. I don't really use the weapons associated with it, but having extra key, well, it's never a bad thing. Now, whether I want to invest in that now, I'm not quite sure. I do like having extra stamina because it does help with your axe pretty well. I think it's one of the second best scaling stats for axe. I'm not sure on that, but I think that's the way it works. One thing I really like about skill is the key pulse, though. I love having an extra key pulse. It really helps when you get used to using the key pulse. Like, I think that ups the maximum, like the minimum amount of key you recover when you key pulse or something. But for this one, I'll be going with... don't really need more stamina right now. Probably would help later, though. This would help most right now and give me more attack power in most things. So that's what I'm going to do, strength. I'm level 71, I just realized. But yeah, let's go to the blacksmith right quick and go through the whole thing. I apparently got a new smithing text. I think that's just a yokai water pot, though. I think. Is that what that... Yeah, it's a yokai water pot. I could use those because I think one of the mystic arts for my axe is when you're in yokai territory or land or, you know, the big gray circles, that it gives you extra damages. So... You know, in a pinch, I'm planning on maybe making a bunch of those. And then if there's something that needs a whole lot of damage, just throw one of them bad boys down and do a lot of damage. I'm not sure if that's a great strategy or not, wasting all those demon horns on that, but that's what I want to do. Anyway, that's how dissembling works. I'm going to try and see if I can actually get anything, you know, better. A lot of times if you disassemble a lot, you can make, you know, refine them into better quality stuff. But I don't have the necessary requirements right now, so gotta go back, get some more items to disassemble. Before I go, though, I want to make sure I'm full on with all the restoratives I need. I accidentally sold a bunch of them at once, because I went to all and uncommon or lower. I'm like, I gotta buy all that stuff back. You know, I sold all my arrows, my antidotes, everything. I want to make sure I'm full to the gills here before we go into a longer mission. We are, so let's get going. Now, I think if we're going to go sequentially, I think we're supposed to go to the three angry gods first and then go to the Magatama of Fire. I want to do this anyway for the guardian spirits first, so that's what we're going to do. So let's save and get going. I still say I'm going to have to fight Okatsu at some point. I don't know what it is, but something tells me I'm going to have to fight her at some point. Then again, I guess I just don't trust spies. And she strikes me as kind of a, you know, kunoichi. A female ninja that's kind of like a spy. I don't trust spies. It's probably why I also don't trust the one guy, the... I don't remember his name now. The dude you met in the first mission at the end of all of it that had the cat? Yeah, him. I don't trust him either. Yeah, it's been about 14 minutes, and apparently this is another one of those maps where there's a big old temple at the top of a hill, I'm guessing. So, not too big of a level, if it's the same level. Probably is. I hope it's not, but it probably is. Well, what do we got in here? Should be a lot of yokai, I think it said. They're wandering around in the hills between the mountains. A lot of people are dying, I can't help but notice. I see four death things already. That should be funny. For somebody, whether it be at my expense or someone else's. I'm gonna wait before going into the deep dark mines. Can I even go down there? Yes I can, but I don't really want to go down there quite yet. I'd rather see what's above ground first. I tend to get lost down there a little bit. I see a spawn thing already over here, so let's go around the outside. That would be why. So I don't get surprised by things later. Take another swing at me. Something's firing arrows at me. I don't like that. Okay, he's coming. He's up on the cliffside. Let's get down here where he can't shoot me. Seems like the wise decision here. Come on. There's a second swing. I'll know third swing, but I can take a swing at you anyway. Trying to utilize my dual swords, like I said, more. It is more, and I think, intelligent to try and up my proficiency in multiple things instead of continuing to, you know, build up on stuff that I don't really need. Anyway, let's take care of that guy up there. At least I don't think I'm gonna need more. The bar was full. Didn't look like I was gonna need more, did it? To me, it didn't. Alright, don't have to worry about arrows anymore in my face. Let's try and get rid of these things that could be trouble. They're not, of course. When I actually remember to do that, they're not. I don't see anything behind there, so I don't think I have to worry about that sign. Is there anything up there? Yes, there is. Good thing I looked. Otherwise, that could have been disastrous if he threw bombs down at me while I was fighting the yokai in here. There's a yokai right there. How far does he come down, I wonder? But let's not wonder. Let's just force him to come over here with a well-placed shot. That wasn't really all that well-placed, Barok. Yeah, I know, thanks. I tried. Oh, that was silly. He's gonna charge. I still don't know how people die to these things at this point in the game. Like, you fought how many tens of these things already? I don't understand how you die to these at this point. If you got this far, don't you, like, come up with strategies to the different enemies you find? Really? I know I'm not the only one that does this. Like, everything that thing does, I have an answer to. If he does his big old multi-combo, you just back it up. If he starts with the big old, like, punch or slash, you wait, and then you dodge, and then you swing. You come up with strategies, right? I guess oh my god. Well, this'll be interesting. I remember you from the beta. I remember you hit, like, a dump truck. Oh god. I'm gonna preemptively do this. Because I wanna try and get rid of at least those two things first. I really was trying to move there. Oh god. Well, that was, I think, a pretty good use of the living weapon. I did not expect that thing to show up here. Oh, goodness. Okay, so I'll be fair. That I can see why people were dying here. I can see. I feel bad now having said that, because I feel like a jackass now, because I just made fun of people and I should have had no right to do such a thing. Stop with Well, that's a new one. I don't remember that happening. Oh, Barok, the situations you find yourself in amuses me so. Yeah, if only it amused me as much. Oh, jeez. Now I'm in the middle of Bumble Screwed Tomb, that's right. Oh, boy. Oh, God, I didn't even see you. I thought you were a statue, you little dick. We'll meet something, I don't know. I'm worse than ex-President Bush when it comes to that saying. At least he got it right sometimes, I think. I love that life steal, by the way, on this thing. Love it. It's not game-breaking, but as long as you can manage to not get yourself hit. You know, I had to reforge that a few times, try and get something a little better than what I had. If you wanted to look at what my weapons were, you know, what bonuses, here you go. I also crafted the hand cannon. I thought, that's pretty good. I like those. I had to reforge it a couple times to get to that. I think this leads back up to where I was. People are dying over here. No, this is way forward. Something just aggroed. Oh, that's like, I saw him up there. I can't see. It's like I'm shooting at a silhouette. I think that was his head. Okay, it was. Okay, this is where, this is where the guy ended up killing himself before. Oh, God! Well, I gotta admit, I didn't see that one coming. I should have. Did I not call that the last time I was in this place? Did I not call right in the stairwell? I know I did. I did. And blocking, it does nothing. It did nothing. Well, that was kind of... Oh, hello, neighbor. Get down here. You were gonna jump on me, weren't you? Oh, man. That was pretty... It got me. I'll admit it. It got me. Oh, God. I can't go back that way. Shit. Guess I gotta go... The only way out is forward. You sons of bitches. Okay, so if I can't go that way, can I go this way then? Up these stairs. I think this was the way forward. Okay, yeah, this is the way back. Okay. Okay. Okay, this is better. At least know where I'm at now. Let's not rest at the shrine, because I just make everything respawn. That'd be silly. So there was a thing here that dropped. Where was the drop? The drop is there. I don't remember that being there. That's pretty cool they changed that. That was pretty good. Did not expect that. In the least, obviously. Otherwise, I wouldn't have done that. Alright, let's see if there's a ladder over this way, as there was in the previous level. Or if there's just more death waiting. Is there a boulder waiting to fall on top of me? I can't really see. I don't think there is, though. Is there anything hiding in the grass like there was before? Does not appear to be so. Oh, God. Okay, charge these things. They're not a huge threat. Oh, that was silly. The reason I like using the axe on those things is because you have a slightly better reach. I thought I did. Oh, you gotta kick that down. I remember now. Alright, well, at least I know where the next objective is. Go up on the cliffside. What'd you die from? You died from cut down by Onyudo. I think that Onyudo is the thing I killed in there. Unless there's another one up here. I think I got took care of that already. Apparently he tried to run. It didn't work out for him. Gonna try and get rid of that. Apparently trying to use your body to defuse a fire trap was not a wise idea. Who would have thought, right? Who would have thought putting your body in the middle of a fire trap was a bad idea? Who would have ever imagined? Stop moving! Wow, that was really good. I'm like nervous now that there's going to be something just aggroed. Okay, that guy over there is an archer. Wonder if I can get a shot from here. Ow! That was like half an inch too high. Okay. Something gonna drop down on top of me? Or from the side? What do you die from? Okay, there's another on you, though. I'm assuming unless that guy like ran away from him all the way up these stairs. There's a yokai over there. I probably better take care of him first. Take care of the lesser demons before we take on the bigger demons, right? That makes sense. Unless the Onyudo's in this room instead. That is, in fact, an enemy, so let's try and get some big damage in first, because I don't really want to fight in there as long as possible. Let's just take him out. I got enough money to buy more rounds. And this is just leading out to the thing, the shortcut, so let's take this. Not really a huge shortcut, but it does bypass a few enemies, I guess. And we can take on old yokai up there. Well, he's a patrol, huh? Alright. Oh, turned around at the worst time. Oh. Stop moving! Okay, this, I don't like fighting here. I'm gonna try and end this quick. This thing is the quicker of the two dispatchers of the weapons I have. And you're done. Alright. Anything on the... Nope. I don't see anything else over here. I'm gonna try and look above first. Make sure there's nothing gonna drop down on me while I'm fighting Mr. Onyudo. What'd you die from? Cut down... Okay, well, I think that's a NPC anyway. Oh god, my shadow scared me. Wouldn't surprise me if there was a shadow enemy. Oh, hello. I didn't know there was a Kadama here. I guess I should have paid a little bit more attention in the thing, shouldn't I? In the menu. There's a guy right there. I did not see you from below.